What is up, guys? Welcome back to my channel. So today I'm going to be talking to you guys about my Nike running shoe collection. I'm just going to be a very high level overview of the shoes. I'm going to give you the basic specs and what I use them for. It's going to be no BS. We're going to get right down to the nitty gritty. So let's go. First up is the Nike Pegasus 35. So this was my first running shoe that I purchased for about $120 a couple years ago. Now you can probably pick them up for a lot cheaper in the outlets since there is a Pegasus 36 version out now. So 10 millimeter offset, Kushlon ZoomX foam on the bottom midsole. You got the padding on the Achilles, pretty much, you know, great shoe for a beginner. I use this shoe probably for everything from traveling on vacation to running on the roads, on the treadmills. This thing will do everything for you if you need it. So it's a great shoe for a starter. So the Nike Pegasus 35. Next up is the Nike Pegasus Turbo 2s. So this is one of my favorite running shoes that I have in my collection because it's super light. They cost about $100 right now in retail, but you can get them cheaper in some colorways. And this has the Featherlite upper, the ZoomX foam on the bottom, which is what the racing Vaporflies use, the elite shoes. They weigh about 7.4 ounces for a size 9. They got the heel cushions on the bottom along with this flexible tongue. Some people hate it, but I think this is okay. You just don't want to lace it up too tight because you could get tendonitis down on the top of the foot like I did. So yeah, this is a great running shoe for faster workouts, tempo, interval runs, things like that. I use this pretty much for all my speed runs. So yeah, an amazing shoe, Nike Pegasus Turbo 2s. Next up, we have the Nike Vaporfly Next Percents. So these are the controversial shoe that everybody wants to get banned because they say that this gives the athlete who has them on an unfair advantage compared to other people who use other brands. So this shoe is Nike's cream of the crop shoe. It'll cost you about $250 and these never go on sale. There's a few colorways out right now. This is the original colorway. There's also a pink one along with a blue ribbon white limited edition as well as a limited edition Egerton version, which is the orange and blue. So you've probably seen this shoe everywhere if you've been to a race lately. This shoe is super light, about 6.6 ounces for a size 9. It's got the vapor weave fabric on top to resist water, heel cushion pads on the back, and a huge amount of ZoomX foam on the bottom to give you that energy return. And their secret weapon, a carbon fiber plate that's sandwiched somewhere between the foam to give you that energy return to make you less tired as you keep running. So this is my go-to racing shoe since it is you know, my favorite shoe. But you know, I'd only use it for racing because I feel like every time I put a mile into this, dollar signs come flying out because the shoe is so expensive. So yeah, this is the Nike Vaporfly Next Percent, Nike's cream of the crop racing shoe. Next is the Nike Vaporfly 4% Flyknit. So this is actually last year's model of the Vaporfly shoe. This colorway is crimson, and this whole shoe is also very light. It's about 6.9 ounces for a size 9. This one has the Flyknit material on top, which some people love because it feels like you're wearing a sock when your foot is inside because it sticks to your feet. This also has a lot of ZoomX foam on the bottom. However, this offset is 10 millimeter from heel to toe. And this also has the carbon fiber plate that's somewhere in between to give you that energy return. So this shoe was last year's model. You can probably get a discount on it right now. I think there's a sale going on at Nike.com for about $187 as of today. So yeah, you can go grab one of these. I use it now pretty much for my really fast runs, like tempo runs and interval runs. So yeah, this is the Nike Vaporfly 4% Flyknit. Next up, we have the Nike Pegasus 36 Trail. So this is my all-terrain running shoe. I use for mountains, woods, anything with bad weather. that, or you need somewhere where you need better traction. So look, as you can see, all these lugs on the bottom help to give you that stability. This shoe also has two dual nice Zoom Air pockets on the bottom to give you that comfort. Got the upper mesh for breathability. The offset on the shoe is about 9.6, and also the weight is about 9.1 ounces for a size 9. So this feels very similar to the Pegasus 35. This shoe is my all-terrain shoe, and it costs about $130 on Nike. I think there's a sale on certain colorways as well, so you should check these out. This is the Nike Pegasus 36 Trail. Next up, we have the Nike Zoom Victory 5 Cross Country. So this is my cross country shoe that I wear for a couple of races. This shoe actually has a carbon fiber plate in the middle to help give you that stability on uneven surfaces. It's got six holes in the back for spikes that are provided when you buy the shoe. It comes with the big spikes as well as the small spikes. The bottom feels very nice, it's got good traction. The top's got the vapor weave fabric, just like the Vaporfly Next Percents. So it keeps you dry while you're running through mud and, you know, any of that nasty terrain. This shoe was pretty easy to clean actually as well. When I raced in these, this shoe was entirely covered with mud. Just took a garden hose, sprayed it down, and it looked brand new. So yeah, this shoe weighs about 4.8 ounces. Also, one note for this shoe, you should get a size, about half a size to one size bigger of your normal Nike size, because this shoe was super tight when I got it in my regular size, so I had to go size up. So one note for that. Yeah, this is the Nike Zoom Victory 5 Cross Country. Next up, we have the Nike Infinity Runs. So this is one of Nike's newest shoes that they have out. They claim that it helps prevent injuries. They did a test on a bunch of athletes, and 52% of the people that wore these didn't get injured as much. I've run about 170 miles in these, and I haven't really gotten hurt either, so they could be right with their claim. The shoe is super comfortable. I use it for all my long runs and my recovery runs. They got the React foam on the bottom for cushioning. The back provides the support, as well as a wider toe box on top and tons of grip on the bottom. So the shoe weighs about 9.7 ounces for a size 9. It's got a 9mm offset from head to toe. The shoe costs about $160 right now retail. There's a few colorways you can choose from, but you can also design your own colorway if you want on the website. So yeah, this is the Nike Infinity Run Flyknit. Last but not least, we have the Nike Vaporfly Next Percent Egadon version. So this is basically the same shoe as the green Vaporfly Next Percent you guys saw earlier. However, this is the limited edition Egadon colorway. Orange is my favorite color, and as soon as I saw this colorway, I knew I had to get it. I haven't even run in these yet. They're brand new. I don't know when I'll run in these, maybe for the New York City Half Marathon coming up, but sometimes I just want to stare at this these shoes because they're so beautiful. The left shoe is an orange color, the right shoe is blue, so they're different colors for different feet. This shoe is the same deal, ZoomX foam on the bottom, but the carbon fiber plate in the middle, vapor weave fabric on top for water resistance. Yeah, and the shoes, same price, about $250, but I don't believe they're on sale anymore since they were sold out, so you might have to get them on reseller websites. This is the Nike Vaporfly Next Percent Echidna version. Thank you guys for watching this video. If you enjoyed the video, please hit that thumbs up button and subscribe. If you have any comments, feedback, or questions, please feel free to leave them down below. And I'll see you guys on the next run.